नमस्कार। आई एम ग्रेटफुल टू ऑल ऑफ यू हु हैव जॉइंड टुडे इन पेइंग होमेज टू महात्मा गांधी ऑन द 73rd मार्टर्स डे व्हेन गांधी जी गेव हिज लाइफ फॉर द कॉज ऑफ पीस एंड हार्मनी। महात्मा गांधीज मैसेज ऑफ पीस एंड कंपैशन रिजाउंड्स विद पीपल ऑफ ऑल फेथ्स वर्ल्ड वाइड एज ही इज अ स्पिरिचुअल एंड पोलिटिकल लीडर of one of the world's most profound and complex cultural traditions. Gandhiji is the greatest apostle of peace the world has seen after Gautam Buddha and Jesus Christ. His notion of peace is focused on tolerance, forgiveness, compassion, oneness, truth force, love force, and soul force through self-suffering and sacrifice. Gandhiji's resonance and impact is felt across the world. Many world leaders have been inspired by him and continue to do so even till today. In all the countries, people have great reverence and respect for Gandhiji. The world today is faced with many kinds of conflicts and diverse types of crises. We see Gandhiji's emphasis on universal brotherhood and peaceful coexistence having an all-time relevance. His teachings are therefore the most upheld principles. In fact, a true testimony of Gandhiji's teachings lies in the fact that mere good ends do not justify bad means. Today in the world, the emphasis is on human dignity and upholding the value of natural justice. There would be no better tribute to Mahatma Gandhi than to rededicate ourselves towards the cause of peace and mutual tolerance. On 30th January 1947, a year before Gandhiji was assassinated, he had said on many occasions to his associates that if I get bedridden due to some disease and die, tell the world that I was not a Mahatma. But if I am on my way to the prayer and someone shoots me from in front and I face the bullets on my chest with Rama's name on my lips and bear no grudge against the person who indulged in this act, then and only then, tell the world that I was a true devotee of God. Perhaps he had a premonition when even 2 days before his assassination, Mahatma Gandhi said in his prayer speech that if I am to die by the bullet of a madman, I must do so smiling. God must be in my heart and on my lips. And if anything happens, you are not to shed a single tear. In his last prayer speech held on 29 January 1948, Gandhiji had said, I can only do as God bids. God is the help of the afflicted, but an afflicted person is not God. I have become what I have become at the bidding of God. God will do what He wills. He may take me away. I shall not find peace by going to the Himalayas. I want to find peace in the midst of turmoil, or I want to die in the turmoil. My Himalayas are here. It was his unique credit that in a world marred by violence and hatred, Mahatma Gandhi stands firm as a man of universal goodwill and a protagonist of peace. What is most striking is that Gandhiji emerged during his lifetime as a torchbearer of peace, and even today, he continues to surprise mankind with his nonviolent methods of resolving conflicts. What is stranger still is the resonance of success of his satyagraha that continues to inspire people across the globe. Nonviolence and the message of peace is a familiar word among the world leaders to settle any dispute. It goes without saying that it is never possible to evaluate how much India and the world owes to Gandhiji. For Gandhiji, peace was not an end by itself. Rather, it was only a sort of a means to ensure better welfare for the mankind. Mahatma Gandhi's lifelong quest was in the pursuit of truth. In fact, he even had said that truthfulness is more important than peacefulness. Non-cooperation was one of Gandhiji's methods for achieving justice. Freedom and justice were supreme for Gandhiji. The Indian supreme values of ahimsa, or non-violence, and compassion were the basis of Gandhiji's philosophy. Practically, he desired solutions for all problems through the means of non-violence and truth. His ideas based on non-violence are entirely important in the new world. They are completely relevant today and will remain so in the future as well. Gandhiji had said, the very first step in nonviolence is that we cultivate in our daily life, as between ourselves, truthfulness, humility, tolerance, and loving kindness. He demonstrated that peace and nonviolence are the two pillars of any peace process that upholds the humanity. These two are inseparable. He said that for bringing full solutions, the means have to be nonviolent action or protest to settle a dispute through satyagraha. In the satyagraha, the parties concerned also understand one main fact, that there is not a clear winner or clear loser. When the conflict comes to an end, both the parties will have to be peaceful upon agreeing wholeheartedly to the terms of the winning conditions. And this is also the fundamental spirit of humanity. Gandhiji was always touched by the pain of others. The ability to feel the pain of others led him to compassion. Compassion coupled with daya or pity led to the spirit of service or seva. Gandhiji's first and foremost inner calling was to alleviate the suffering of others. This was the inner calling that he identified and invested in it, and serving and helping people to establish their self-respect and dignity. He had a keen desire to restore the dignity of all human beings. This reflects beautifully in the shloka which used to be recited in the daily morning and evening prayers in Gandhiji's ashrams. Natvaham kamae rajyam, nasvargam na punarbhavam, kamae dukkha taptanam, praninam artinashanam. I do not crave for rajya, nor do I want swarga or moksha. I merely want to alleviate the sufferings of people. The greatest degree of inner tranquility came to Gandhiji from the development of love and compassion, non-attachment and non-possession. The more we care for the happiness of others, the greater our own sense of well-being becomes. Cultivating a close, warm-hearted feeling for others automatically puts the mind at ease. This helps remove whatever fears or insecurities we may have and gives us the strength to cope with any obstacles we encounter. It is the ultimate source of success in life. Gandhiji's example demonstrates that as long as we live in this world, we are bound to encounter challenges and problems. Even during any difficult circumstance, Gandhiji did not lose hope and become discouraged. He faced the challenges with the understanding that it was not just him who was undergoing difficulties, but everyone was undergoing suffering. This realistic perspective increased his determination and capacity to overcome troubles. Armed with this attitude, for him, each new obstacle became yet another valuable opportunity to improve and overcome challenges. Gandhiji rose beyond his personal sorrows and joys and shared the happiness and sorrows of people. He became more compassionate and developed both genuine sympathy for others' suffering and the will to help remove their pain. As a result, his serenity and inner strength increased, as did his resolve. Gandhiji believed that the person who can control his emotions, his fears, his desires for revenge and violence will win every single time. Gandhiji challenged all people to develop their courage and compassion in their day-to-day life. In today's troubling times, the need to build a peaceful and inclusive society towards a more sustainable future is the pressing need. The values and ideals of Gandhiji are more important in today's context. Throughout his life, Gandhiji dedicated himself to the practice of truth, satyagraha, non-violence, compassion, and kindness. These principles, if embodied in our daily life, will help us address the pressing challenges the world is facing today. Although we may have differing views and ideals, the ability to understand and to live together is the only sustainable path for humanity. Gandhiji showed this through his trait of oneness with everyone and treating people with the utmost respect. He was certain that it was his duty to alleviate suffering. His heart was full of compassion and he took full responsibility for his actions. Gandhiji was extremely conscious of self-respect, but was willing to disregard personal insults in the interest of the community. He possessed limitless patience and discernment. He strove to lead a life of dignity, but at the same time, he was trying to cultivate the qualities of equality, simplicity, humanity, and to make these a part of his daily life. This endeavor to attain harmony and unity between the outside world and his inner life a process that would continue all his life. In Gandhiji's personality, we see the true signs of inner strength in his compassion, which by nature is gentle, peaceful, and soft. But it is very powerful. He always remained humble and maintained a sincere attitude in facing challenges and worked resolutely towards a fair outcome. He expressed his views in public, in his speeches, and through his writings. In all the actions planned as strong countermeasures, he always told people to do it without anger or ill intent and asked them to recall their desire to practice compassion and assume responsibility for helping prevent the other person from suffering the consequences of his or her acts. Today, we have a unique opportunity to take the lead. Open a new page in human history by learning from Gandhiji to address the global challenges. It is because our own human existence is so dependent on the help of others that our need for love and compassion lays at the very foundation of our existence. Therefore, we need a genuine sense of responsibility and a sincere concern for the welfare of others. Even after 7 decades have gone by since Gandhiji passed on, in every part of the world, his relevance is felt as strongly as ever before, and his visions and actions are of an enduring significance for all times and places. Gandhiji stands out as the champion not only of political democracy, but also of economic and spiritual democracy in today's world. Gandhiji believed that moral degeneration is the root cause of all evils, including conflicts. For Gandhiji, the principle of satyagraha, or non-violent resistance and civil disobedience, was by non-cooperation with evil through the moral values of love force, truth force, and soul force through self-sacrifice and suffering. His belief and actions that social change for establishing justice and dignity of humans is both less harmful and more sustainable than achieved by non-violent means stands the test of time. Mahatma Gandhi's environmental practices were based on conservation of natural resources, which were often misused and overused for the sake of development. Gandhiji had warned about the unsustainability on the global scale and had said that greed will be the main reason for the environmental degradation and the ecological crisis. He had predicted this a century ago. Equality for women within the society was a principle Gandhiji passionately believed in. His vision of Sarvodaya, the welfare of all, becomes very relevant in the crisis of internally displaced people and migrants. And he may well have kept in mind the very basic unit of human organization, a village or a county, while talking about Gram Swaraj. Gandhiji's life provides an excellent role model of the ways of spiritual development in his crusade to oppose the unjust system. The techniques he crafted, like satyagraha, and the strategies he followed in his public life give us insights into how spirituality can be applied to improve human condition in today's world. The applications are not India-specific, but universal. Decades ago, stress was classified as epidemic of modern life. The Gandhian way of life is the best guide to practicing the coping mechanism that induces relaxation, calmness, inner peace, absence of anxiety, and remaining positive. The Gandhian principles of freedom from fear and care for all are a perfect prescription in these times of crisis. Gandhiji's emphasis on healthy lifestyle, positive thinking, prayer, meditation, chanting, and empowerment of self-care and care for the community would make perfect sense in these times. 73 years after violence brought his life to an abrupt end, it is a life worth revisiting, for it carried in its chapters the mild but unassailable truth that peace is a positive force and that it can still move the human race away from darkness towards light. Mahatma Gandhi had declared, "Am I going to be silenced after my death? I will proclaim my faith even in death and speak from the grave." What was this faith that he wanted to proclaim from the grave? It was faith in truth that was God. It was faith in the goodness of all, as all are capable of truth. It was faith in the goodness of mankind, It was faith that despite the faults and upheavals, humanity would move towards goodness, because truth, that is God, is only interested in the welfare of its creation. I take this opportunity to thank the Indian Mission and the Indian Cultural Center for remembering Mahatma Gandhi on the Martyrs Day. My special thanks are to all of you who have joined me online. I will end with the peace benediction in Sanskrit for the universal welfare, followed by Ramdhun. Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinah, Sarve Santu Niramayaha, Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu, Ma Kashchit Dukkha Bhag Bhavet. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shantihi. Let all be happy. Let all be healthy. Let all experience auspiciousness. Let no one be overwhelmed by grief. Om, peace, peace, peace.